Cultural heritage primarily protects our sense of who we are. It gives us an irrefutable connection to the past, to certain social values, beliefs, customs, and traditions that allows us to identify ourselves with others and deepen our sense of unity, belonging, and national pride. Hi everyone, this is your tour guide Rafaela. Let us explore the beauty of our cultural heritage through a virtual gallery walk. This will be truly exciting because you will see for the very first time all of my artworks inspired by the cultural designs, patterns, and accessories from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao cultural motif. But before we begin, let me tell you a story on how I was able to hone my skills in creating designs using different shading techniques. Shading is the process of adding value to create an illusion of form and space. Using different shading techniques, I created a wide array of textures, like hatching, cross-hatching, blending, and stippling. Hatching is added to the leaves of the rose. I used circulism to give the petals of the rose a fluffy and soft look, while I used stippling to create a hard illusion in the heart. The cultural motif of my artwork was inspired by the Ifugao's cultural patterns. The diamond-shaped design is called Kinati Banglan, which represents the ancestors of their time. The alternate pattern that looks like an S is called the Ginulot. The symbol represents Manaut, the great deceiver, and his progeny. The alternate triangle pattern is inspired by the symbol of the carry-all bag of the Ifugao's. This is a symbol of their carry-all bag called the Ambayong, where they keep their small knives, charms, amulets, and betel nuts. The gown that I designed was inspired by the intricate patterns of Visayas and the vibrant colors and unique patterns of Mindanao. The cultural communities of Mindanao's Maranao, Bilaan, and Yakan are my top favorite cultural patterns. The curved lines and repeated triangles embedded in the straps and circles in the upper part of the gown are Visayas-inspired intricate patterns. The textiles of Yakan are mostly characterized by the vibrant colors of red, pink, and yellow. The Bilaan pattern I used in my gown are the tiny black polka dots. The Maranao patterns I used in my gown were the big spiral lines colored in yellow and red. For the Maranao, yellow is associated with royalty and high status, while red stands for bravery. Some indigenous houses of the Philippines have a significant colonial history during the Spanish era. Some houses were preserved and protected as part of our cultural heritage. The painting I made was inspired by a classic Philippine icon, the Bahay Kubo. Bahay Kubo, or Nipahat, is a type of stilt house indigenous to the cultures of the Philippines. This was designed to endure the climate and environment of the Philippines. It is also known as payag or kamadig. My painting consists of a background, middle ground, and foreground. The background of the painting are the blue sky and fluffy clouds. The middle ground are the Bahay Kubo or Nipahat, the tree, and the river. The foreground is the downhill where you see mostly are grasses and stones. After all the shading techniques, creating own cultural patterns, designing a gown inspired by a cultural motif, and painting the iconic Philippine Bahay Kubo, it is time to plan the fun part of being an artist, the tie-dye shirt planning. This is my tie-dye shirt planning I made before the actual tie-dye. The planning helped me prepare before the actual tie-dye. In the tie-dye shirt planning, it has the purpose of the pattern that I wanted to make, the materials that I will be needing, and the elements that will be featured in my tie-dye shirt. Are you ready to see the finished product of my tie-dye shirt? This is my finished product. I made a spiral tie-dye pattern. I used primary colors of red, yellow, and blue. Did you know that many cultural communities have their own tie-dye technique? The Tiboli tribe makes their tinalak fabric through a tie-dye process. Our cultural heritage reflects and shapes our values, beliefs, and aspirations, thereby defining one's national identity. It is important to preserve our cultural heritage because it keeps our identity as a person. It defines of what and who we are. I hope you enjoyed our cultural heritage
virtual gallery walk. Remember, let us preserve and protect our cultural heritage for the next generations to come. Bye!